With Cowboys training camp truly underway, it is time for an updated 53-man roster projection. Also, by the look at the practice squad as well, we'll go position by position, 53 guys in total, starting at the quarterback spot. I've got two, Dak Prescott, Garrett Gilbert. That means we cut both Ben DiNucci and Cooper Rush. Dak's a lock. I think Garrett Gilbert is safer. DiNucci and Rush are both on the bubble right now. Of course, if you don't like the quarterback room, I get that. So get your votes in here for me. Do you think the Cowboys need a better backup quarterback? Let me know what you think. Y for yes or N for no. Over now to the running back spot. Very straightforward, identical to last year's. Ezekiel Elliott, Tony Pollard, roster locks. They're making the team this year. In the end, I went with Rico Dowdle over Jaquan Hardy, Brandon Knox, Nick Rawson, and Shewu Olanolua, who you might see one of them on the practice squad side. Stick around here. But I went with Dowdle because I want to carry a third back, and he does offer special teams value. Now, I don't think Dowdle's a roster lock, but I would almost put him closer to safe as we sit right now than directly on the roster. But he is by no means guaranteed anything as we sit right now. So we're going through the entire roster, the 53-man projection here. So what I want you guys to do right now, it's kind of Madden style it here, rate the Cowboys roster for me on a scale of 1 to 100. Now, I could have done 0, but like, you know, no one's going to put a 0 in there. So rate it for me, 1 to 100. This is the pinned comment, by the way, on today's video. So if you get that ad break here on YouTube, scroll on down and let me know how you rate the Cowboys roster on a scale of 1 to 100. Over now to receiver, and I will go with 6. There are 3 very obvious roster locks. Amari Cooper, Michael Gallup, and CeeDee Lamb. The 4th, 5th, and I'm going to project 6 spots, though, are not locked and loaded. There are several undrafted free agents. You'll see some of them in the practice squad side of things here who are in the mix there. And the Cowboys could also go light, especially if Cooper is good to go. They could go 5. So in the event that the Cowboys choose to only carry 5 receivers, who are you guys cutting? Noah Brown, special teams gunner guy, type in NB. Cedric Wilson, the best of the receivers right now, plus punt return value, and the most expensive, type in CW. Or if you want to cut the rookie, which I don't want to, but it's an option, Timo Fiocco, type in SF. Get your votes in right now. All right, tight end now. 2 guaranteed roster locks. Blake Jarwin, Dalton Schultz. Duh, right? Jeremy Sprinkle, a guy I consider pretty safe right now. And then a guy who made the roster last year, Sean McEwen. And they've also got Nick Eubanks, Artavius Lynn. I'm going to cut those guys. But I think the tight end 3 spot is a battle. And tight end 4 might come down to McEwen, Eubanks, Lynn, and even fullbacks like Nick Ralston and Shewu Olanolua, because Mike McCarthy and Kellen Moore group that position together in long. But I think Jarwin Schultz are locked and they're going to play the vast majority of the snaps at tight end for this team. If you guys want to bet on the Cowboys this year, do it with our sportsbook partner, BetUS. Head over to chatsports.com/bet. When you put down at least $100, you will get a 125% deposit bonus when you use promo code Cowboys125. So if you want to make some money betting on the Cowboys, do it at BetUS. Chatsports.com/bet. Promo code is Cowboys125. All right, over now to the offensive line. And I got 10 guys here who I've got making the roster. Tyron Smith, Connor Williams, Tyler Biadasz, Zach Martin, Lael Collins, Connor McGovern are 6 roster locks. The rest of the positions are up for grabs. Matt Farniak could be involved here. I think Ty Nsekhe makes it. I think Josh Ball, given the team's investment draft-wise in him, ends up making it. I wouldn't be surprised if the Cowboys chose to cut a Brandon Knight or Terrence Steele. Now, I think Knight is going to get some run at offensive guard, and that might put him over the edge over a Matt Farniak. Both guys started games last year, and both guys were not that great. Now, Steele played better down the stretch, and that's a big deal for the Cowboys. But both of these guys could also be trade bait. They've started games. Guys, look around the NFL. Chaz Green is still in the NFL. The need for depth along the offensive line is always high. So the Cowboys, if they don't make the roster, I promise you we'll look into trading one, if not both of them. To the defensive side of the ball now. I'm going to start here at the edge rusher spot. We'll come back to defensive line. Randy Gregory, DeMarcus Lawrence, Chauncey Golson, Terrell Basham, and my fifth pick, Bradley and I. Now, apologies to Rondell Carter. I think in the end, assuming Lawrence and Golson, everyone's healthy, if the Cowboys carry five, they might not, it comes down to these two players, Dorrance Armstrong and Bradley and I. I want Bradley and I on this roster. The Cowboys, not sure they feel the same way. So we'll see what ends up happening. But pick one to keep. Type D for Dorrance Armstrong, or if you like me, type in B for Bradley and I. The intriguing part for me now comes on the interior of the defensive line. Neville Gallimore, Brent Urban, Ose Odighizuwa, those three are roster locks. That leaves two, potentially three spots for guys like Carlos Watkins, Quinton Bahana, and a player I'm not including on this, Tristan Hill. Now, Hill might be on the injured list in some capacity for week one, so I'll not include him on here because we'll mention him in cuts again. But even if he's still injured, the Cowboys might cut him. Like, this is a pivotal camp for him, and he's not out there. He's banged up still, coming off that knee issue. So, unfortunately for Hill, that's a big-time red flag. If he does get back, which would be nice for the Cowboys, he might beat out a Carlos Watkins, for example. Now, Watkins will not rush the passer that much, but he can be a decent run stopper. I think a better run stopper than, say, Tristan Hill is. So I think Watkins, a change from my last or initial roster projection, I'll put him on here for now. I'll also keep Quinton Bahana on here. Listed at 330, a little bit under that. Might have slimmed up a little bit. If he can be a run stopper and give hope to fatties only, that would be a big deal, at least for me, moving forward. Linebacker, no change. I'm going light. Jalen Smith, Micah Parsons, Leighton Vander Esch, Jabril Cox, and Keanu Neal. My apologies to guys like Francis Bernard, who's coming off a hamstring issue or has hamstring issue right now, and, you know, Anthony Hines and Luke Gifford as well. But I'll go light at linebacker so I can go deeper elsewhere. So which linebacker do you think plays the most snaps in 2021? I'm going to lean with Micah Parsons because I don't trust Jalen Smith to play that well, and I don't trust in the long run Leighton Vander Esch to stay healthy either. So I'm going Micah Parsons. But get your votes in for me. Which linebacker plays the most snaps this season? Over to cornerback now, and I'll go maybe just a little bit lighter than what we've gone in the past. Trevon Diggs, Jordan Lewis, Kelvin Joseph, Nashawn Wright, guaranteed roster locks. I would say Anthony Brown is almost a roster lock. I consider him very, very safe from that perspective. C.J. Goodwin is still going to have to fight for his role, but as a key special teamer, I think he makes it. We will get to Reggie Robinson later on, but he is in a fight for a roster spot as we sit right now. I'm trying to get to 100,000 subscribers. Producer Britt has not just threatened Producer Jack's job, my job as well, if we don't get there before my baby comes in November. So help me out. If you want daily Cowboys videos, subscribe right now. To safety, and I will be honest, I was this close to putting free agent to be on this list. I couldn't do it. I went with DeMonte Casey, Donovan Wilson, two roster locks, and then Israel Mukwamu and Jerron Curse as the players fighting for a roster spot instead. Special teams, as long as Greg Zuerlein's healthy, these are all roster locks. Zuerlein, Brian Anger, and Jake McQuaid as well round out my 53-man roster projection. But I believe in going above and beyond here at the Cowboys Report. I'm going to give you practice squad projections as well. And if I go 500, I feel great. First, some notable cuts. Malik Turner on the roster last year. I'm going to go with the other three receivers instead. Tristan Hill, who again might be part of the injured list, but that's just too early for me to know for sure. Dorrance Armstrong. Sorry, buddy, bye. Maurice Kennedy, Darian Thompson. All those guys could be practice squads as well, but maybe they get claimed by a different team. So on now to the practice squad. Quick note, by the way, not finalized, but expected. The plan is going to be 16-man practice squads for the Cowboys this year. So keep that in mind. Ben DiNucci, he makes it. Shea Ola-Anolua, three receivers. Brandon Smith, injured currently, so maybe an asterisk there. TJ Vasher, and also Texas receiver Brennan Eagles. You're welcome, Texas-based Cowboys fans. Nick Eubanks, a tight end. I put him in there for you guys. He wasn't going to make it if it was 12, but I made the extra spot, so it's cool. Isaac Alarcon, you're welcome. Matt Farniak as well. Defensively now, Rondell Carter, I like that one. Austin Feliu, Francis Bernard, Anthony Hines, and Luke Gifford all line up at linebacker. I got Reggie Robinson on there. I might be pushing it on that front, but I don't want to quit him quite yet. Deontay Burton also has some ties to Dan Quinn, by the way. And also Tyler Hoyle, the safety from Purdue, also by way of UConn, who offers some great speed.